Welcome back to another Black Lightning Canon Recap. I'm your host, Terry. Today, I'm talking about Episode 9, The Book of Little Black Lies. So, man, we had a good episode. I really like this episode. I'm kind of continuing on the theme that I talked about last week, and that is the idea of Anissa and Jefferson kind of doing the whole detective thing as opposed to the street hero thing. We get them kind of first uncovering this mystery, tracing the clues, you know, kind of, I wouldn't say trope, but just kind of what we see before, going through the books, as they say. We got to go through the books and look at the clues. And so they were doing a little bit of that, which I really enjoyed. I mean, that on top of Gambi's information with his part in it, kind of helped them piece together what they were looking for and what they needed to attack. Now, on top of that, we get the fallout of Jennifer having her powers and Anissa kind of going head first with telling her the deal. Like, look, I'm Thunder. I got powers too. Dad's Black Lightning. What's good? And so that kind of starts a whole riff. Now, the thing I'll say about that is it's not unexpected. When we had Anissa kind of react to her powers the way she did, I mean, there's a lot of stereotypic ways to do it. And, you know, one is, I'm not going to tell anybody. I'm going to keep this to myself and deny it and keep trying my powers out until I finally accept it. And, you know, the whole, I'm going to love these powers. I love having powers type thing. That's all Anissa. And then, of course, there's the other stereotype of, oh my God, why did you tell me? I hate this. I just want to be normal. And so they try to show the dichotomy of having two sisters react very different ways. And so, of course, Jennifer's, I don't believe you, even though you just lift my bed up. I don't believe you, even though I just came crying to you about how I melted my phone. And so all that happens, and it was expected, for me at least, but I think it played out well. This is the first time I really felt these two girls feel like sisters. And I don't have sisters. I'm not around sisters, so I don't know how they interact most of the time, but it just, for me, felt a little too natural and easy when they interacted. This is the first time I felt like, okay, they're real sisters about it. And then we kind of go through this miniature thing of you deal with your sister and Black Lightning will deal with everything else. But I'm glad they cut that off early because that would have got tiring, so I'm glad she was just came out like, look, we can act like I'm going to listen to y'all and sneak around and do this, or I can just go with y'all. Now, she is mad disrespectful, and in a show with Black culture, that is intolerable, but however, I'll allow it. Because they call up Jennifer later, where the mom was like, in this family, I don't know how your friends do it, but in this family, my favorite line in the movie, in this family, young ladies who roll their eyes and who give their parents silent treatments can pay their own bills. Which, you know, is the step before you can get out. You want your own rules, you get your own house. You know how that goes. So I enjoyed all that. I enjoyed everything with the small interactions. I enjoyed Henderson at the very beginning where we get this whole thing where he's telling Black Lightning, look, if I don't make it back and people say that I'm dirty, just let my wife and kids know I'm not. And that's a lot of layers we could talk about. It was just strong for me. It felt real to me. It was good. It fits with the Black Lightning tone. So I absolutely love that. We had a lot of good moments in this. But again, so getting into it, we finally get the team up, when Anissa gets her costume from Gambi and she's officially Thunders, Lightning and Thunder. They go wreck shop. It really felt this show, I said prior to, it felt like Meteor Man, a lot of parts from Meteor Man that you feel in it, which was the Robert Townsend classic. But there's also a mix of the other Robert Townsend classic, the Disney original, Up, Up, and Away, which was about a world of superheroes that everybody knew about. But there was also a family where everybody had powers. And so this really this episode in particular kind of evoked that out, where you're dealing with the dynamics of your children having powers, taking it different ways, teaming up with your younger daughter, who is a young woman now, and that it's time for her to do her thing, and kind of letting her make her own mistakes, but also making sure she's safe. It was a lot of good things about it. And then Black Lightning with, I never remember the woman's name, but his wife, his former wife, that I'm talking about. And it was a great line, again, great lines, where she's just like, do you think you talking about laying down your life makes me feel any better? Where usually people will be like, I'll never let anything happen. I'll die before something happens to them. And it's like, well, that's not the point. That's not going to help. And so I like they pointed that out. It's just a lot of cool stuff in it. We are advancing slowly, which I'm appreciating. They really introduced some weird elements. The Lala coming back to life, the whole embalming process with Lady Eve, the whole tattoo on Lala. Like, it's a lot of weird elements they're introducing, but they aren't speeding into it. And I like that, because we got time for Jefferson and his daughter to come partners. We got time for the youngest daughter to understand she has powers, and we're slowly building up to it. So I'm glad they didn't explain Lala and everything else that was going on. This gave us a chance to breathe, where there's so much in a short season to learn about Black Lightning that the filler episodes don't feel like filler. They feel like they serve a purpose, even though they're not advancing the main overall plot. It still feels like it's serving a purpose. So one unique thing with Black Lightning this season so far is that I really enjoy these episodes where we're not rushing into explaining everything, because I still can take a lot away from the stuff you're showing me. So having a real good time with it. As far as the grade, I'm going to give it a crisp A-, around a 91%. The ending really kind of pushed it over. Even with the cheesy superhero walk away from the exploding building type stuff, I still just like the whole overall thing. Like I said, it feels like Meteor Man shutting down the crack house. It feels like Up in a way bringing in the youngest or one of the younger siblings into the fold. It feels good. So that's my thoughts. I want to hear your thoughts. Go to the comment section. Let me know what you thought about this episode.